स्विच ऑफ योर माइक्रोफोन। मिस संगीता मिश्रा, प्लीज स्विच ऑफ योर माइक्रोफोन। मिस संगीता मिश्रा, प्लीज स्विच। थैंक यू। ऑल राइट, सो वेयर वॉज आई? सो दिस नॉवल इज अ वेरी बिग नॉवल एंड इट हैज अ लॉट ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स, अ लॉट ऑफ यू नो प्लॉट्स एंड देन सब प्लॉट्स गोइंग ऑन पैरेलली। अ फ्यू माइट थिंक इट एज अ वेरी चैलेंजिंग नॉवल। इट इंडीड ऑन द सर्फेस इट विल लुक लाइक अ वेरी चैलेंजिंग नॉवल, बट एज वी गो मूव मूव इन। यस, समबडी हैज स्विच्ड ऑन द माइक्रोफोन। मिस्टर
Somebody
प्रशांत
has switched
मलिक,
off.
मे आई प्लीज रिक्वेस्ट यू टू स्विच ऑफ योर माइक्रोफोन।
मिस्टर प्रशांत मलिक, मे आई प्लीज रिक्वेस्ट।
या प्लीज, थैंक यू। ऑल
ओके
राइट,
मैम.
सो दिस नॉवल ऑन द सर्फेस इट माइट सीम टू बी अ वेरी बिग नॉवल एंड विद अ लॉट ऑफ कैरेक्टर्स। इट माइट बी डिफिकल्ट, इट माइट सीम डिफिकल्ट टू डील विद नॉवल्स, बट यू नो वन थिंग, द फनीएस्ट पार्ट ऑफ ऑल द लिटरेरी नॉवल्स एंड ड्रामा इज they are all very relatable. Now let me tell you something. Whenever, let me tell you a trick. Whenever you are dealing with a literary novel or a drama, I'll be mixing English, Hindi, and Odia for your convenience so that all of you can understand it better. Okay. So whenever we are reading an English novel or an English drama, we should make one thing very sure that it is nowhere different to the present scenario. Okay, the things that are happening or that are taking place in the novel or in the drama are the things that are happening in this present scenario or this present era also. So we do not have to panic. For example, let's take a very simple example of a Shakespearean play called The Merchant of Venice. Okay. Apart from the diction, apart from the language in which the play is written, everything else will look like a Hollywood or maybe a Bollywood movie. All right. And yesterday, when I was taking class, somebody was asking me how is literature and movies related. Of course, it is related. If we can read about plays, jodi ame drama manko bisore pori parchu, tahale why cannot be movies be a part of literature? They can be a part of literature, they can be a genre of literature. Ago kalare ebe ama pakare you know we have multiplexes, we have cinema halls, and we go to the cinema halls and we watch movies, but in that time, maybe during the 16th to the 20th century, there was no such cinema halls or movie theaters. So plays and dramas were the only means of entertainment for the people, and they went to the theaters and they saw movies and drama movie sorry plays and dramas just like we are watching movies. So movies are of course and a very you can consider them to be a part of literature. And as I said, every novel or most of the novels and most of the drama or plays are generally related to the present day movies and present day Hollywood or Bollywood movies. Like when I re when I when I'll tell you about the plot summary of this novel, Tom Jones, you will actually realize that it is no less than a Bollywood movie or maybe a Hollywood movie. Mr. Digambar Chan, may I please? Okay, thank you. All right. All right. So now let's start with the novel. One more thing I would like to add, while we are dealing with a novel, when you are reading a novel or when you are dealing with a novel, there are a few things you should keep in your mind. Okay, the first thing is a novel might half of your work is done, half tomorrow adha kama novel ro sette bele hei jae jete bele tomane characters ro na jani dio, characters mankaro role jani dio. Okay, characters are the main bars, or maybe we can say they are the touchstones of novel. जदि तुम गोटे कैरेक्टर विषय में पढ़ीदल गोटे सब कैरेक्टर्स मान विषय जाणीगल ताल यू डू नॉट हैव टू
हेलो मैम, हेलो
या
हेलो,
यस
ये कौन सा नॉवेल है मैम?
दिस इज
हेलो, हाँ
टॉम जोन्स हेलो
मैम, ठीक है.
टॉम जोन्स ओके ओके सो द मोमेंट यू गेट टू नो अबाउट ईच एंड एवरी कैरेक्टर द नेम्स ऑफ द कैरेक्टर एंड व्हाट डू दे डू यू कैन नो अबाउट द कैरेक्टर्स हेलो आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू प्लीज
लिटिल
डू नॉट क्रिएट एनी काइंड ऑफ डिस्टर्बेंसेज व्हाइल आई एम टीचिंग प्लीज स्विच ऑफ योर माइक्रोफोन्स द नॉवेल आई एम डीलिंग टूडे विथ इज टॉम जोन्स बाय हेनरी फील्डिंग ओके दिस इज द फर्स्ट नॉवेल of your semester Tom Jones by Henry Fielding I'm repeating again Tom Jones by Henry Fielding
मैडम, व्हाट इज
okay
द मेन थिंग ऑफ द नोबेल टॉम जोन्स?
listen I am taking a session I told I will be answering your questions after the session let me at least take the session let me complete the session and then I'll be answering your questions okay thank you so much All right. So, for your reminder, let me take the session, and after that, I will give you at least 10 to 15 minutes to answer your questions. All right. Okay. Now let's start with the novel. So let's start with the writer, Henry Fielding. Henry Fielding was considered to be the founder of English novels. Okay, Henry Fielding and Samuel Richardson both were considered to be, the stalwarts of English novels. The major novel of Henry Fielding is Tom Jones. Why? Because in Tom Jones, you will see a lot of Henry Fielding happening. As in, जदि तुम टॉम जोन्स रो कैरेक्टर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स देखिबो, इफ यू सी द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ टॉम जोन्स, यू विल फाइंड सम ट्रेसेस ऑफ हेनरी फील्डिंग इन दैट कैरेक्टर इन द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ टॉम जोन्स और यू विल फाइंड सम कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ टॉम जोन्स एंड हेनरी फील्डिंग वॉकिंग पैरेलली ओके लाइक ओके लेट्स सी हाउ ओके So he was born in a family of earls and dukes and had quite a wealthy family or ancestral background. His father married twice. He was a close friend of and colleague of George Littleton, who was then the statesman and turned out to be an important patron in Fielding's life. Okay, remember the name George Littleton. Okay, this we will discuss about him in while we are discussing about the novel. All right. Now, Fielding's life. During his early ages, he once tried to elope with an heiress. Heiress, HEIRESS. Heiress. All right. Now, what is basically an heiress? Someone who is an heir to a large number of property or maybe to a large wealth. All right. The one who receives some sort of large property from their ancestors. Okay, so during his young youth time, Henry Fielding, I'm talking about the writer. Okay, remember I'm talking about the writer. He tried to elope with this lady called with this lady. His name is not given in the history. Who was an heiress to a ancestral to a huge ancestral property. All right. He stayed away from home, but had to return after 18 months as his father was no longer able to pay him money. So we can say that we can say that Henry Fielding was a man of his own thought. And generally, what happens, all the literary artists, okay, the poets, the novelists, and the writers, they have a mind of their own. They are very independent people who do not like to be a part of this monotonous world. They will always find some escape, they can't hold themselves in the regular routine life. They will have their you know, independent life. They will some stay away from homes, and some are great walkers who can walk miles and miles, and who can live in the lap of nature and can write beautiful poetries and proses and novels and drama. So literary artists or literary authors or writers were generally like this. They had an independent thought of life. They had an independent view of life. Now, the only two options he had to, after he returned, the only two options he had to was to become a full-fledged writer or a coachman. He chose the former. Okay, दो options थे उसके पास, या तो वो एक writer बनते, या तो उस time पे coachman is someone who rides you know, the horse carriage. Okay, you know, what we can say, रिक्शा वाला, you can say in today's world. If you say, he had two options, दो option थिला तांगो पाखरे, either से गोटे full fledged writer बनी थांते, नहले गोटे kind of रिक्शा वाला ही बनी थांते, because when he left home he was very young. He was essentially a satirist who wrote mostly on political corruption during those years. Okay, so now let me tell you one another fact about these literary writers, authors and poets students. They all were not only they were independent, not only they had a mind of their own, not only they were they lived in their own area of not only they lived in their own zone, but they also they were also great satirists. Most of the writers were great satirists. Okay, those times were the times when corruption, you know, 18th century, 19th century, 20th century, 21st century, all these centuries were filled with corruption, were filled with wrongdoings, evil deeds. Okay, there was immorality, there was what we can say, it was a time of immorality, it was a time of necromancy, it was a time of somebody has asked the question, what is a satirist? I'll tell you. Okay, just hold on, hold some patience, I'll tell you. Okay, yeah, so those were not very good times. Those were the time when the world was evolving, and along with evolving, it was also it was also going in a wrong direction. So satirist, here the work of a satirist means a person who generally put forth the human vices. Human vices means the follies, the blunders of human beings, like corruption and like this immorality, who puts it in a way, in a very satirical, in a very comical way. All right, in a very comical way, in his works, in a poem or in a novel or in a drama. Am I clear now? Did I answer your question? Subhashree Pradhan? Okay, let me repeat myself. A satirist means a person who writes about or who mentions or who portrays the human follies or the human vices in a comical way in front of the world by writing it in a novel or writing a poem about it, or maybe writing a drama, or maybe picturing a drama on it. All right. Okay, so in those days, what I was telling about is, in those days, corruption was a very unavoidable part of the society. Corruption, one is corruption, and the second was adultery. Okay, these two were the most important and the most unavoidable human vices. Human vices means jo mane manisa mankaro kharap prakruti. All right. These two were the most common human vices in the 18th, 19th and 20th century. And these writers like Samuel Richardson, say Alexander Pope, or Henry Fielding, all these writers took the torch of writing or portraying these corruption or portraying these human vices in form in the forms of their writings. All right. Then Henry Fielding was married to Charlotte Cradock. This time after a successful elopement. Now see, this person is so funny. Say, aage to gote, I told you about the first elopement. Elopement means polaji bata, gharu polai bata. Okay. First, he eloped with a very wealthy heiress. And that time, he was, he couldn't, they couldn't go long because they were both very young. So, maine basically durku jai parleni and because both were very young. And apart from that, Fielding didn't have money to afford a living with his so-called eloped wife or so-called eloped lover. But this time, again, ethara authore se gharu poleile with another girl named Charlotte Cradock. Okay, and this time, though he tankara gude job lagi jaithila and he had a quite legible earning. So this time, the elopement or jo se mane gharu jo पलायन करते दैट वाज सक्सेसफुल ऑल राइट एंड दीज टू डेटेड ईच अदर फॉर नियरली अबाउट 4 years ओके हिज पोर्ट्रेयल ऑफ शार्लॉट कैन बी इजिली सीन इन द नॉवल टॉम जोन्स वेर ही फॉइल्स शार्लॉट एज सोफिया वेस्टर्न इन टॉम जोन्स डिस्क्राइब्ड एज अ ब्यूटिफुल हाई स्पिरिटेड जेनरस माइंडेड गर्ल हु कैन मेक एनी वन फॉल इन लव विथ herself. Now remember these two names, okay? One is Charlotte Cradock and the second is Sophia Western. Remember these two names? We'll discuss about them when we go deep into the novel. All right. Okay. So this is how we came to know about this is only you need to know Henry Fielding for now, because you know these parts of Henry Fielding or these attributes of Henry Fielding is shown in the novel called Tom Jones. Okay. All right. Now, before going into the novel or before going into the plot of this novel, let us discuss about the characters, the main characters. You know, learners, this novel has a lot of characters. It has 17 important characters, okay, or the lead characters, and nearly 10 to 11 add-on characters. Okay, not very important characters, but they are add-on characters. We can find them here and there. Okay, but add-on characters whom we can find here and there. Okay, so the first character, the most important character with whom, who is the opening, we can say who is the opening character of the novel is Squire Allworthy. Agude jinso tamane notice koriba students, a novel re na bahut mane jo characters guda ko achanti seman karo na guda ko similar achi. Okay, Squire, Squire achi gote, Square स्क्वायर गोटे अच्छे ओके सो बहुत गुड़ाक क्यारेक्टर्स एमती अच्छा जो मान ना कोलाइड कर सो मु तुमको ना ना प्रोनाउंसिएशन सहित आई विल आल्सो टेल यू द स्पेलिंग्स ऑफ दोस क्यारेक्टर्स सो दैट यू कैन रिमेम्बर देम जदि इफ यू वांट टू राइट इट डाउन यू कैन नोट इट डाउन आल्सो ओके सो द फर्स्ट क्यारेक्टर और द ओपनिंग क्यारेक्टर ऑफ टॉम जोन्स इज स्क्वायर ऑलवर्दी एस Q-U-I-R-E, Squire, Allworthy. Okay, Allworthy. He was Tom Jones' guardian. Now, let me give a small description about, let me tell you a small fact about Tom Jones. Tom Jones, this novel is all about finding Tom, first is about it, this novel is about finding Tom Jones' parents. Because Tom Jones, amku, in the beginning of the novel, Tom Jones ko as an anath portray kara hai chi. Okay, jahara maa, anath mane jahara maa bapa bisaram kichhi jana nahi. Okay, he is called to be a foundling. F-O-U-N-D-L-I-N-G. Okay, mane jahara maa bapa bisare kichhi kuha hai ni. Okay, a novel ta, Tom Jones ro bapa maa ko khoji batu arambha karikina, टॉम जोन्स केमती तार बिलवेड और तार गर्लफ्रेंड सोफाया को बाहा होची तार भीतर जर्नी ओके दिस नॉवेल इज अ जर्नी फ्रॉम टॉम फ्रॉम सर्चिंग टॉम जोन्स पेरेंट्स रियल पेरेंट्स टू टॉम जोन्स गेटिंग मैरिड टू हिज वन एंड ओनली बिलवड सोफिया ऑलराइट ओके सो स्क्वायर ऑलवर्दी तो ए मणिषटा स्क्वायर ऑलवर्दी जी he was the first person to meet Tom Jones. Say, Tom Jones ko first dekhitila as a small little baby. All right. Se dekhila ki gote chhuate achi, taro ghare enti thuai chi, ghare samnare thuai chi, and taro kehi naanti, akhe pakhe taro kehi naanti, he doesn't know se kahara chua. All right. So he was Tom's guardian. Who got Tom as a foundling? He is a gentleman, and he believes in Tom, despite of the fact that Tom was not his own son. So Squire Allworthy is a very is a man of morale, is a man of good deeds in the novel. So Tom ko bahut bhal paaye. Okay, though majhire se man karo discrepancies ase, majhire se man karo disturbances ase, tanko relationship re, but then he loves Tom and he believes in Tom. Okay. Then comes Bridget Allworthy, B-R-I-D-G-E-T. ये हो चंदी हमारा second character, B-R-I-D-G-E-T, Bridget, A-L-L-W-O-R-T-H-Y, Bridget Allworthy. ये हो चंदी Squire Allworthy's sister. She is Squire Allworthy. Squire Allworthy के the person who found Tom Jones. Squire Allworthy रो sister. Okay, she is unmarried initially. I mean, in the opening of the novel, she is unmarried. But later, she ends up marrying Captain Blifil. He is another character. We'll come to him later. All right. Then comes Mr. Wilkins. Mr. W-I-L-K-I-N-S Wilkins. Okay, he is the house help of Miss Bridget Allworthy. She was a woman who was hated by all. And Mr. Allworthy gave her the task of finding Tom's real parents. Okay, she is not that important a character, but yes, she was given the responsibility. Mr. Allworthy, je Tom ko khoji thile, se tanku responsibility de thile ki tu ja, aur tu kon karibu na, Tom ro je real maa bapa, tanku khoji ki aani ki mate kaha. Okay, that was the task given to this lady. Okay. Then finally we come to the hero, the protagonist of the novel called Tom Jones. Okay, he is the protagonist of the novel. He is believed to be a child of low birth. Now say time re ebe bi tumhe dekhibo society re gote mane there is a taboo in the society ki jo chhua ra bapa maa ko bisoy re kahaku jana nai se chhua ko ame gote kinte ame tanku gote bahut माने यू नो एम्पैथेटिक वे रे देखो वी सी देम टू बी हमको तंको ऊपर दया असे हमको तंको पाई खराब लगे बट देन यू नो देयर इज दिस स्टेट ऑफ माइंड तंको देखे कि हमको टिके ऑकवर्ड लगे ओके दैट आहा बिचरा आहा या संग्रेंती हबर थिला आहा माने यू नो टॉम वाज टॉम को समझते सेंती देखुतले जेहेतु ता बापा मा विषय रे काको जणा नथिला तेणु करी ताकु तार फ्रेंड्स होंतु रिलेटिव्स होंतु नेबर्स होंतु समस्त ताकु सेई नजरिया सेई वेर देखुतले कि आहा छुआ बिचा छुआर केही नहांती ऑलराइट एंड ही इज कंसीडर्ड टू बी इलेजिटिमेट कीपिंग ऑल दिस फैक्ट्स इन असाइड ही वाज अ गुड लुकिंग जेनरस एंड पैशनेट मैन Okay, the novel mostly portrays his attempts to pursue Miss Sophia Western and his as his beloved or wife. Now, kehi jana mate pochar thile na, what is the theme of the novel? So as I said, this novel is basically a romantic novel. Okay, it's basically a romantic novel which oscillates or which goes on in between finding Tom's parents to Sophia's to his marriage with Sophia. Okay, basic kichi, you know, this novel is not at all a rocket science. Bohut hi plain, simple, basic, ground level novelata. Okay. Then comes Jenny Jones. Jenny Jones is portrayed as a bright Jenny Jones, J-E-N-N-Y, Jenny, J-O-N-E-S, Jones. Jenny Jones is portrayed as a bright young lady in the initial phases of the novel and is also wrongly assumed to be, and is also, sorry, not wrongly assumed, and also is assumed to be Tom's mother. Okay, so Jenny Jones is a very young and a very beautiful lady. In the initial phases of the novel, she is... Okay, somebody asked me, what is the meaning of romantic? Okay, I'll explain it to you in the doubt clearing session. Okay, I request all of you, those who have any kinds of doubt, to please keep it on hold so that I can explain it to you by the end of the session. I told you will get, I'll give you legit 10 to 15, 15 to 20 minutes, okay, to clear up all your doubts. Let me finish this session first. Okay. All right. Okay, so Jenny Jones was a young lady in the initial phases jahaku ame later time re novel re dekhiba ki taku samaste kochanti ki se Tom Jones ro real mother. Okay, aur se confess bhi karuchi kete sata kete micha eta ame pachhe janibaku paiba. Okay, let's keep this a suspense. All right, then Dr. Blifil, Dr. B-L-I-F-I-L, Blifil, a good friend of Mr. Allworthy, falls in love with Bridget Allworthy despite of being married. Now see, here is the term adultery that I was talking about. Okay, adultery generally means jo, you know, just a minute. Okay, so I'm sorry, adultery generally means you know, to have sexual relationships or to have a kind of sexual tension or to have a kind of sexual attraction towards somebody else, even if you are married or even if you have a husband or a wife. Okay, so this was the adultery I was talking about. Jandi, hey loco. Dr. Blifil, he fell in love with the Allworthy sister Bridget Allworthy. He fell in love with Bridget Allworthy, but Dr. Blifil was already married. Now here comes the adultery thing that I was talking about. Okay, how he loved that girl so much ki se ta bhai ko kahila ta Dr. Blifil ra bhai ra na hochi Captain Blifil. Okay, se tara bhai ko force kala ki तू जा ताको बाहे जा काको ब्रिजेट को बाहे जा. All right, now we come to the next character, which is Captain Blifil, C-A-P-T-I-N, Captain B-L-I-F-I-L. Okay, so Captain Blifil is Dr. Blifil's brother. Okay, though physically unattractive, yet Bridget and Captain Blifil fell in love with each other and ended up getting married. Okay, so keeping aside the fact that Dr. Blifil loved this girl, this lady called Bridget, okay, their his love couldn't be successful because he was already married. So se kon kala se ta bhai ko kala ki bhai re mu to bhai parivi tu hi bhai jata se to. Okay, so it's kind of a, you know, comic scene between the two brothers. Just imagine the conversation between the two. Tame mane ताकु निज माइंड रे तमे प्ले कर, हाउ फनी इट वुड बी. गोटे भाई आ गोटे भाई को कहुचे, भाई रे मु ताकु भल तो पाउचे किंतु मु ताकु भाई परबिनी बिकॉज़ मु तो भाउज को भाई छी, तण कर तू ताकु भाई. सो दिस इज व्हाट हैपेंस देयर. ओके, व्हिच इज वेरी बेसिक. इट हैपेंस इन टुडेज वर्ल्ड आल्सो. ए प्रकार जिंस आज कालीर दुनिया रे भी होउची. ओके, that's why I told that this novel is not a rocket science. Jo characters goda ko novel re dekhuchi sei characters goda ko real life re bhi achanti. You just need to relate it, and then studying of novel will be, you know, a very pleasurable journey for you all. Okay, Captain Blifil, so he was unattractive physically, he was not that good looking like Dr. Blifil, but then both Bridget Allworthy and Captain Blifil fell in love with each other and they ended up getting married. Tapre tankaro gote, you know, they also had a baby. His name was मास्टर हिज नेम वाज मास्टर ब्लिफिल मास्टर ब्लिफिल सो ब्लिफिल नारो तीनटा कैरेक्टर्स हमें देखी सारलोनी एठी गोटे होची डॉक्टर ब्लिफिल कैप्टन ब्लिफिल एंड देन मास्टर्स ब्लिफिल डॉक्टर ब्लिफिल एंड कैप्टन ब्लिफिल बोथ आर ब्रदर्स एंड मास्टर ब्लिफिल इज द सन ऑफ कैप्टन ब्लिफिल एंड ब्रिजेट ऑलवर्दी सो डू नॉट गेट कंफ्यूज ओके ना गुड़ाक सामने जो ये गुड़ाक लगाऊ प्रिफिक्स गुड़ाक लगाऊ से गुड़ाक मन रखी जमी डॉक्टर ब्लिफिल डॉक्टर ब्लिफिल इज अ डिफरेंट ह्यूमन बीइंग कैप्टन ब्लिफिल इज अ डिफरेंट पर्सन एंड मास्टर ब्लिफिल इज अ डिफरेंट पर्सन ओके देन कम्स अनदर कैरेक्टर नेम पैट्रिज पी ए आर टी आई डी पी ए आर टी आर आई डी जी ई पैट्रिज अ स्कूल टीचर who is a cast out from the community accused of domestic violence dekho domestic violence ame kete sunu ki aajkal ro duniya re bhi houchi semiti hi houchi jente agaro duniya re houthila okay so here also domestic a scene of domestic violence is there not a scene of domestic violence but he was accused of domestic violence mane taku ta upre jo ame ko na hindi re kon te ilzam lagaitla uske upar ilzam lagaya gaya tha that he is doing domestic violence upon his wife all right sethi pai taku se mane community ru bahar kar deithile abhi se community ru bahar karibar system ebe bhi in some areas or in some villages ebe bhi jinso ta hue okay so this man was cast out of the community okay to ye community bahar re rohthila kintu gote alga na re rohthila tar community bahar na hochi little benjamin okay little benjamin na re little benjamin ro gote micha na re gote pseudonym re se kon kortla na community bahar re rohthila okay aur later times re kon hue na tom jones aur little benjamin or you can say patridge they become very close friends okay then mrs patridge now she is the actual villain se kon karithile na ki she was a very jealous and a very selfish woman okay and she was the one who accused her husband of domestic violence se tanko husband ko domestic violence ra डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस रो जो इल्जाम लगे थे तांको हस्बैंड ऊपर काहें के लगे थे काहें के ना आमे गोटे कैरेक्टर विषय पढ़ी थी नेम जेनी जोन्स जे की माने हु वाज अक्यूज्ड ऑफ बीइंग टॉम जोन्स रियल मदर ओके सो शी वाज डाउट से डाउट कले हु मिसेस पैट्रिज डाउट कले कि तांको हस्बैंड हु इज मिस्टर पैट्रिज और जेनी जोन्स भितरे किछि गोटे अफेयर अछि एंड जेनी जोन्स जेतेबेले ए कथा मानिगला दैट शी इज द मदर ऑफ टॉम जोन्स सेतेबेले मिसेस पैट्रिज को लागिला कि तांको हस्बैंड मिस्टर पैट्रिज इज द फादर ऑफ टॉम जोन्स सेति पै रागरे से कोन कले ना ए आउट ऑफ रेज शी अक्यूज्ड हर हस्बैंड फॉल्सली अक्यूज्ड हर हस्बैंड ऑफ डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस एंड हिज एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ व्हिच हिज हस्बैंड वाज कास्ट आउट ऑफ द सोसाइटी देन वी कम टू अनदर square character s q u a r e square character okay he is a failed philosopher okay who stays in the Allworthy's residence and acts as a friend and advisor to Tom and Blifil now eta ko Blifil this Blifil is master Blifil master Blifil ke captain Blifil aur Bridget Allworthy ro puo okay so in that way ये जो मास्टर ब्लिफिल और टॉम जोन्स दी और कजन हेले ओके टॉम जोन्स बड़ो भाई ये दिस अदर वन दिस मास्टर ब्लिफिल ये छोटो भाई सो ओके समबडी इज आस्किंग हु इज पैट्रिज पैट्रिज इज अ कैरेक्टर डियर पैट्रिज इज एक्चुअली अ स्कूल टीचर ओके आई एम रिपीटिंग अगेन पैट्रिज इज एक्चुअली अ स्कूल टीचर हु वाज कास्ट आउट ऑफ द कम्युनिटी when he was accused of doing domestic violence with her wife okay and mrs patridge who is the wife of mr patridge she accused mr mane wrongly accused mr patridge of of treating of beating him or hitting him because she doubted or she was suspicious of the fact that Mr. Patridge and Jenny Jones both are having an affair and Mr. Patridge is the illegitimate father of Tom Jones. Am I clear? Did I answer your question? Yes? Okay. Thank you. All right. Then we come to another character, Square. S-Q-U-A-R-E. Square. Okay. Basically, he is a failed philosopher. Philosophers, we all generally have a mindset that philosophers are generally they have a life of theirs. They do not care what happens in the world. They have their own lifestyle where they live, and you know, they mostly generally agro enti ote ye thila conception thila ki jo mane philosophers ki jo mane you know writers, philosophers, they are mostly, you know, they failed or they become famous only after their death. So this was a very common conception of, or a perception, and even now some people think like that. Very sadly, even now some people think that. Okay. So basically, a failed philosopher who stays at the Allworthy's residence. Okay. So ye huchanti gote failed philosopher je ki Allworthy mankaro ghare rohuchanti. Allworthy is a title, jenti more title Sabbath. So mo ghare je rohuchi, we will say that so and so is staying at Sabbath's residence. Okay. Thik semti Square square boli monisa. Say he was a so-called failed philosopher who used to stay at the house of the Allworthys. Okay, he was a good friend and advisor to both the cousins, Tom Jones and Master Blifil. Alright, then comes Thwackum. Thwackum, this is a very tricky name as well as a very tricky spelling. Spelling is T-H-W-A-C-K-U-M. I repeat, T-H-W-A-C-K-U-M. Thwackum. All right. He was a teacher who was employed, tuition teacher. Say, Blifil, Master Blifil or Tom Jones, ro tuition teacher thile. All right. Then comes Black George. Ye gote agute nua character. Black, B-L-A-C-K, Black George, G-E-O-R-G-E, who was Jenny Jones. Okay. So Jenny Jones, as I told, she was a young lady. Okay, in the initial, when the novel opened, she was a young lady, and she was wrongly assumed to be Tom Jones' mother. Okay, taku samaste wrongly accused kole, jenti Patridge ko samaste wrongly accused kole of domestic violence, thik sei pare Jenny Jones ko samaste wrongly accused korthile of being Tom Jones' mother. Okay, aur se mane bhi thila. Okay, so mane bhi thila ki se Tom Jones ro real mother, but the reality was something different, and we'll get to know that when we go into the plot of the novel. Am I clear? Did I answer your question? Mr. Mukesh Rautra, did I answer your question? Okay. Okay, I think he's not here. All right. Now we come to yet another character named Black George. He was the father of Molly Seagrim. He has good relation with Tom, but you know, later there are discrepancies. Okay, somebody has a question. Like Othello novel is, it's not Othello, it's Othello, O-T-H-E-L-L-O. Othello, no, it is not a novel, it is a play by Shakespeare. Like Othello novel is related to Omkara movie, similarly any movie related to Tom Jones. Any movie can be related to Tom Jones. I would answer any movie, any straight cult romantic movie with a lot of characters can be related to Tom Jones movie. Okay, when we go into the plot, you will realize that it is more of a movie, and any movie can be made. All right. I would like, learners, I'm getting distracted when I'm seeing your questions. So it's a humble request. Please keep your questions till the end of the session, and we will discuss all your questions. Okay. Now, Black George. Black George is the father of Molly Seagrim. Okay, Molly. is the father of Molly Seagram. He has a good relation with Tom, but later they have a few disturbances in their relationship. Now we will know about who is Molly Seagram, who is Black George. Okay, just for now, just remember he is the father of Molly Seagram. All right, and he is not a very rich person. He is a poor person in the novel. Okay, and he is the father of Molly Seagram. Remember the name Molly Seagram. MollySeagrim. We'll discuss about this character later. Okay, then comes Blifil. This is the Master Blifil that I was talking about, who is the son of Captain Blifil and Bridget Allworthy. Okay, now Tom Jones, as I told you, everybody was very sympathizing towards Tom Jones, because everybody thought that aha bichra chhuaro kehi nahanti. Okay, so but Blifil, on the other hand, he loke taku ete importance do nathile. Okay, so that's why Blifil was very jealous of Tom. Generally, you know, child psychology, I'll tell you about my personal experience. Even I had this kind of jealousy. You know, I am the elder sister in the family, but when my younger brother came to this world and my parents, they gave all importance to him because he was a baby. Because I was also very small. I was also very young. I was very jealous of him. I used to, you know, beat my brother for no reason. I used to sometimes pinch him. I used to do all, you know, evil things. Okay, so it happens. So I developed a kind of jealousy towards my younger brother. So same was the case with Blifil and Tom Jones. Blifil was actually jealous of Tom because he thought that Tom is getting all the attention. Okay. And sometimes, what will he do is sometimes he will make Tom fall in some difficult situation out of jealousy. Then comes Sophia. Sophia, now she is the heroine of the novel. Like we say, hero heroine ke bina movie nahi chal sakti. Similarly, Tom Jones is the hero, so called hero of the novel, and Sophia is the heroine. She is the daughter of Squire Western. Now, Squire Western, I'll discuss about this character later. Now, the spelling is S-Q-U-I-R-E, Squire, W-E-S-T-E-R-N, Western. All right. Okay, so Sophia is a daughter of Squire Western, and she is a very lovely lady. Like generally, jenti you know, English ki Hindi movies goda kare hue students, the hero of the novel is very charming and very handsome, with a, you know, tall, dark and handsome personality, whereas the woman is always very docile, very cute and very beautiful, pretty. Okay, so similarly, Tom Jones, who is the hero of the novel, he is very handsome and he has a very handsome personality, very good looking, whereas this girl Sophia, or the lady love of Tom Jones, is very cute and very beautiful. And she is very, and also very intelligent woman. Okay. And the entire novel is about, the entire novel is about Tom Jones and Sophia's love story. Then comes Squire Western, S-Q-U-I-R-E, Squire, W-E-S-T-E-R-N, Western. Okay. He is one of the neighbor of Mr. Allworthy, and he is the father of Sophia. Okay, so Squire Western, S-Q-U-I-R-E, Squire Western. So there are two Squires, S-Q-U-I-R-E, Squire Allworthy, who is Tom Jones' guardian, and there is the Squire, S-Q-U-I-R-E, Squire Western, who is Sophia's father. Okay, he is a hunter, and you know, during the first and he drinks a lot. Okay, he was an alcoholic. He drank a lot, and he was the father of Sophia. All right. Then comes Molly Seagram. Now, who is Molly Seagram? Now we discussed about Black George. Let me repeat again. Who was Black George? Black George was in this novel he is portrayed as a poor man whom Tom helped a lot. Okay, and his daughter's name is Molly Seagrim. He was the daughter of Black George, and Tom and Molly had developed a relationship, and they had a affair initially. Before loving Sophia, Tom had a relationship with Molly Seagrim. All right. The last of all the important characters is Mrs. Seagrim. Mrs. Seagrim was Molly's mother. Now, what Molly does is, Molly becomes pregnant later. Okay, and nobody knows whose child is that. Okay, and this is, and you know, this is so dramatic. This happens in movies. This happens in, say, Hollywood movies or Bollywood movies. Okay, she becomes pregnant, and nobody knows who is the baby's father. All right, so in that way, in that time, Tom comes as a hero. That I'll take the baby. I'll give name to the baby, and eventually he is known to be the father of the baby. Okay, but that is not the reality. We'll know the reality later. All right, now come Mrs. After Molly Seagrim comes Mrs. Seagrim. Mrs. Seagrim is Molly's mother. She is more like her partner in crime, and she helps Molly hiding her pregnancy. Okay, she is a very supportive mother, but supports her daughter in a very wrong way. She helps her daughter hide her pregnancy, and she is more like a partner in crime for her daughter. All right, so these are the 17 important characters in the novel. Now let's go to the plot. Okay, I will just tell you the important events happening in the novel. All right, so kindly listen carefully, and you will know the importance of all the characters now. Okay, so the novel starts with Allworthy finding a baby boy at his home. Okay, and the baby boy didn't have anybody beside or around him. There was nobody, so he brought that baby boy to himself, to him, and he he takes care of the baby as his father. All right. Okay, and then in the first scene, we also see that Bridget Allworthy marries Captain Blifil, and then they give birth to this boy named Master Blifil. And then this jealousy thing between Master Blifil and Tom Jones starts. Okay. After that, we come to a leap of 12 years. Okay, we come to the leap of after the first chapter or after the first book. See, Tom Jones is a very heavy book, is a very big book, which has nearly about 18 sub-books or 18 sub-chapters. Okay, and after the first chapter, we take a leap. Okay, this generally happens in serials, Ekta Kapoor serials. Okay, today you watched an episode, and tomorrow there is a leap of 25 years or 12 years or 15 years, like that. So similarly, in the novel also, the writer took a leap of around 12 years. Okay, now we come to the time that skips after 12, that comes after 12 years. Okay, Blifil and Tom Jones are brought together, but they have different treatment from other members of the family and their friends, because as I said, everybody considered Tom Jones to be very first of all, they sympathized with Tom Jones because he had no one, and second of all, Tom Jones was a very helpful man. Because why? Because he supported Black George and his family. Sometimes he used to steal apples from his farm, and he used to steal eggs and apples and all the edible items to give it to Black George. Now people were asking, who is Black George? So Black George was, we can say he was the house help, or he was one of the servants of Allworthy, whom Tom Jones helped a lot. And Black George's wife is Molly Seagrim. Am I clear now? People who had problem with Black George, am I clear now? All right. Okay. Then So that is why when people came to know about Tom Jones helping Black George, they were, you know, they grew this natural love and affection towards Tom, saying that अरे कितने भल पिलाटा कितने सहायता करूँ ची मन करो ये माने गरीबों घरों रो लोगों माने मन को कितने सहायता करूँ ची. So he developed this natural, so everybody developed this natural tendency of love and affection towards Tom. But on the other hand, Blifil thought that you know, Tom is taking all his attention and he was very jealous about Tom. Okay, sometimes Tom will you know, youngsters, or we can say as you know, kids, we do a lot of things. Okay, ame luchi luchi kina bahut enti badmasi goda ko karu jota ki ame jani thau nahale ame bhai bhoni ame kaaku gote kahitau jaha ko ame sabutu beshi trust karu. So Tom jo choto moto badmasi goda ko kare seta se asiki Blifil ko kahe. Ab Blifil jehetu he is very jealous of Tom, se kon kare na jai kina Allworthy को, Mr. Allworthy को सबु कह दिया, and as a result of it, Miss Tom को Mr. Allworthy ठू गाली पड़े. Okay, general tendency. Movie संधि कोर्टीले. When I was I used to be young, my you know, I used to put my brother into all these difficult situations so that he gets scoldings and beatings from my parents because I was jealous of him. So this is generally the psyche of children. Okay. When there are two children in the family, and you know, if one feels that the other one is getting more importance, then this is what generally happens. Okay, then okay, so now again, Tom is a very friendly person, very friendly guy. Okay, he is very young and very attractive and also very friendly. Okay, so jaha se tabhi mise taku se nijaro फ्रेंड बने दिए. ऑलराइट, सो ऑलवर्ड मिस्टर ऑलवर्डी रो आ गुटे नेबर थिले SQUIRE स्क्वायर वेस्टर्न. ओके, सोफाया वेस्टर्न रो फादर. ओके, दे ही वाज द नेबर ऑफ मिस्टर ऑलवर्डी एंड टॉम रो तांको सहित भी बहुत माने भलो संपर्क थिला. यू नो, देयर आर अ फ्यू पीपल हु कैन एक्चुअली बी फ्रेंड विथ एवरीबॉडी. से माने तांको निजो एज रो होंतु कि तांको ठू बड़ो होंतु. ओके, सो सेमाने तांगो निजो किछटा लोक थांते सेमाने तांगो निजो एज रो होंतु कि तांगो टू बडो एज रो होंतु सेमाने समस्तंगो मन जिनि माने जिति वटा जानंति. एंड टॉम वाज दैट काइंड ऑफ अ पर्सन. ओके, एंड ही इम्प्रेस्ड स्क्वायर वेस्टर्न एंड आल्सो हिज डॉटर सोफिया. सो सोफिया वाज आल्सो वेरी इम्प्रेस्ड बाय टॉम. ओके, but and Tom also fell in love with Sophia along with time. Dheere dheere kon hala na jente tango friendship bodhila, both of them fell in love. But yaade agute scene re kon hechi, agute subplot kon chalichi ki Black George ro jo jhiyo Molly Seagram, okay, se bhi Tom sahita tara bahut bhalo samparko, and they eta past ro katha. Okay, eta agru hei sarichi e jinsa ta, and they develop an affair, and tapre Molly becomes प्रेग्नेंट. और टॉम ऑलरेडी तब बापा को कही देते हुए कमिट कर देते हुए मॉली रो बापा को कमिट कर देते हुए दैट नो, दिस चाइल्ड बिलोंग्स टू मी, आई विल गिव अ नेम टू दिस चाइल्ड, आई विल मैरी मॉली. बट इवेंचुअली व्हाट हैपेंस इज टॉम फॉल्स इन लव विद सोफिया एंड सोफिया आल्सो फॉल्स इन लव विद टॉम. सो तापरे कौन हुए ना, टॉम एक्चुअली रिजिस्ट हिमसेल्फ इन द फर्स्ट इन द माने initially what happens is Tom resists himself and he you know, he tries to keep himself away from Sophia because he has already committed to marry Molly. Okay, but then after that Molly is not very good person. She is not a very good she is not portrayed as a very good lady. Okay, she it is later realized, Tom later realizes that Molly has a lot of affairs with lot of other people. And that is why he decides to leave Molly, and he confesses his feeling to Sophia. All right, but this is not the end, students. Now comes the real bundle of problems in all there in Sophia and Tom's life. Now Allworthy falls ill. All right, and so you know, the doctor says that Allworthy might have the chances that there are chances that Alworthy might die because he is very ill. Now, who is Alworthy? Alworthy is the person or the guardian of Tom Jones. Okay, he fell ill and Tom was very, and that made Tom very upset. Okay, tapre then there is a scene, the lawyer comes in and he reads about the will where Alworthy states that this much of part is going to Blifil, this much part is going to Tom. Okay, and that makes Tom think that okay, jodi esobu jinsa hochi loke kete bale will bananti jete bale they are about to die or when they see that okay, death is nearing, at that time they make wills. Okay, so now Tom now made up his mind that okay, maybe my father or my guardian or whosoever, so obviously he was his guardian, so he might be like a father to Tom. So Tom thought that nahi abhi bapa will abhi bapa mori jibe bodhe chali jibe, so setipai se will banauchanti. Okay, but eventually what happened, Alworthy came back to his health. Okay, he was again healthy and said, you know, Tom was very happy. He became very happy and he went and he drank a lot. Okay, he drank a lot of alcohol. Okay, and Blifil, and on that day Blifil and Tom had a fight with each other. Kichhi gote hai the wo. Okay, Blifil comes and accuses Tom and calls him a bastard. Okay, and Tom, he was already drunk. आउ जेतेबेले गोटे मनीष पी की थाए सेतेबेले इफ यू मेक हिम एंग्री देन द सिचुएशन इवन वर्सन्स. सो व्हाट हैपेंड वाज टॉम टर्न्ड आउट टू बी वेरी एंग्री एंड ही हिट्स ब्लिफिल. ओके ओके देन अगेन नाउ हियर अगेन व्हाट हैपेंस इज टॉम नाउ on this day Tom goes to Sophia and confesses his love and says that I will constantly be in touch with you and we will be in love, we'll be getting married. Okay, but then as he was drunk, Molly takes unfair advantage of that scenario. Okay, now this is again a very cinematic thing that happens. Okay, a girl who wants to take revenge from his lover, the lover ta kuch chhad dechi and the girl wants to take revenge. So what she does is she goes to that person and makes him drink a lot of alcohol, and then what happens is she tells to the whole world that this guy has slept with me and we are having affair. So this is what Molly did. All right. Okay. So okay, so this is what Molly did, and this later came into the ears of Sophia. Okay, so and Sophia and Tom, they develop a kind of disturbance in their relationship, obviously, because no girl is ever going to tolerate that his lover or the person he loves, she loves or about is or whom she is going to marry has slept with somebody else or has an affair with or has an adulterating affair with somebody else. No girl will actually tolerate. So there is this distraction between Tom and Sophia's relationship. All right, now here comes another character. Okay, Sophia's aunt comes in. Okay, now Sophia, auntie, or we can say what we call PC Bua. Okay, she comes to their house and she proposes Sophia's father that Sophia should marry Blifil. Who Blifil? The jealous Blifil, the master Blifil, who is always jealous of Tom. Okay, who is always competing with Tom. Sophia doesn't want. So what if she has broken up with Tom, but she doesn't want to get married to Blifil? Okay. Okay. So what does now? This Sophia's father is very furious. Okay, when Sophia opposes to the marriage, he becomes very furious. And what does he do? He locks Sophia inside a room and he plots against Tom Jones and he sends him out of the town. All right. Tom wants to reconcile with Sophia, and let's see what happens then. Okay, Tom is, and while Tom is out of the town, he meets this person called Little Benjamin. Okay, Little Benjamin, who? Okay, will you please bear patience, Mr. Mukesh Rautrai? I'm going one by one. Okay, this is a very big novel, so I'm trying to cover every aspect. Just wait, I will answer your question. Okay. So, where was I? So this is what happens when somebody distracts me in the middle.
Tom Jones tries to reconcile.
Yeah, Tom Jones tried to reconcile with Sophia, but then as he is set out of the town, so he leaves the town. And while he is going out of the town, he meets this person called Little Benjamin. All right. Okay, so here also, Benjamin becomes a very loyal friend and a very loyal guide and fellow guide and a very good friend of Tom Jones. And he is the person who is Tom's friend from till the end of the novel. All right. Okay. So now what happens is Tom is in another town. Okay, he left his old town. Now he is in another town, and there he sees here another cinematic thing happens. Okay, he sees that a lady, her name was Mrs. Waters. She was attacked by some local goons. Okay, and what does Tom do? Tom saves that lady from all those goons. And later what happens is Tom again ends up building a relationship or building an affair with that lady. Okay, and later that lady also turns out to be married. Okay, so eta ella velku, while Tom is having this affair with this lady, what happens is Sophia ta town ru a town ku dodi dodi auschi in search of Tom. Okay, Sophia somewhere, she comes to know about the reality of, that Tom Wong and Molly, actually, it was kind of an abduction that Molly did to Tom and everything was a lie, Tom is innocent. So she comes running to the place and Mrs. Waters, the person, the girl with whom Tom is having the affair now, okay, both of them are living in a hotel. Okay, and Sophia somehow finds that address of Tom and comes to that hotel, and she gets to know that Tom is with another lady. Okay, see the kind of tension that is happening, the kind of confusion that is happening. Tom loves Sophia, Sophia also loves Tom, but he is also having a lot of affairs, and some of the affairs are intentional, whereas some are unintentional. Some is to get a companion or maybe someone to have a friend, but then everything is falling apart for both Sophia and Tom. Okay, so when Sophia knows about this, she is furious with anger and she leaves her muffler in that hotel so that Tom gets to know that Sophia was here and she knows everything about the affair between Tom and Mrs. Waters. Okay, and then Sophia goes to London. And she is very furious with Tom. All right, now later, while this is all happening here, what happens in the Allworthy's place is, there is this tension going on between all these people, between Bridget Allworthy and between Jenny Jones, that who is Tom's actual parents. Okay, now this is the time we come to know about the reality of Tom's parents. How? We'll discuss that. Okay. Now Tom again, now this is another very funny scene that is coming up. Sophia goes to London, टॉम भी ताको फॉलो करे करे लंदन गला बट इन लंदन टॉम फॉल्स इन लव विद अनदर लेडी ओके हुज नेम इज नैंसी ओके एंड विद नैंसी ही इज हैविंग अ वेरी सीरियस रिलेशनशिप ओके एंड नैंसी एंड ही टॉक्स एंड ही आस्क द फादर नैंसीज फादर टू गेट मैरिड टू नैंसी ऑल राइट एंड no but somehow that relationship doesn't work okay so so again he goes back to Sophia means you know you see the kind of confusion that is that the writer is trying to create one after the other we know that Tom and Sophia will eventually get married at the end of the novel but then you know to bring in that masala to bring it that punch you know like in every movies in every Hollywood and Bollywood movies it happens not generally Hollywood movies but Bollywood movies it happens that you know directors they want to give that extra punch okay agar hero heroine ek bar mein mil jate to maza hi kya aayega who will buy the movies who will buy the tickets for the movies so there has to be this thing okay there has to be this tension there has to be this confusion from which all these you know hero and heroine has to go and finally they will meet at last okay so here also now Sophia is staying at London at Mr. At Mrs. Lady Bellaston's house okay she is a distant relative of Sophia okay so eventually in London because Sophia is very angry on Tom and she is not ready to listen to anything that Tom says so okay somebody is asking please mention the character of Nancy once again so Nancy is a character in London who meets Tom at London and both of them start developing an affair am I clear okay but due to some but then their relationship also doesn't work because Tom actually for every other lady Tom is just developing a mere temporary attraction okay he loves Sophia that is inevitable but for all the other ladies it is those you know timely temporary attractions that he is having and that is why his relationships with any other lady is not working All right. So Sophia is very angry. So she doesn't want to reconcile things with Tom. So what happens is the lady with whom Sophia is staying in London, Tom again ends up having a relationship or having an affair with that lady. That lady's name is Lady Bellaston. Lady Bellaston is a distant relative of Sophia, who is not. That important but yes the only aspect the only role she plays is they have Tom and Lady Bellaston have a very short affair for a very short span of time okay okay so now here again you know Sophia comes back to his play to her place being very angry with Tom and again this tension happens at Sophia's place that Sophia eloped mane Sophia ta gharu pale jai thila and his father is furious and his father again locks her inside the room okay and then Tom is again accused of so many things Tom is accused of Tom is accused of just a minute okay so now here comes another character Mr. Fitzpatrick okay Mr. he is a character who comes in the middle of the novel who thinks that who thinks that his wife is having an affair with Tom okay and what happens is he might be the husband of that lady with whom Tom had an affair in the hotel okay he comes and he accuses Tom of having affair with his wife and they both have a very tough fight with each other all right and Tom in order to save himself what does he do he stabs Mr. Patrick on his Mr. Fitzpatrick on his stomach. All right. And as a result of which, he is sent to the jail. All right. Now we come to the last part of the novel where everything falls back into place. A happy ending. Okay. So now what happens is Tom comes out of the jail. There is news that Mr. Fitzpatrick is not dead. He's still alive and he's still under treatment. Tom comes out of the jail and the tension at their home and Tom's home is cleared. People know that Bridget was actually Tom's mother. She is actually Tom's real mother. Okay, that thing is now disclosed. Bridget, who? Bridget, Mr. Allworthy's sister, who got married to Captain Blifil. She is the real mother of Tom, and she gave money to Jenny Jones to admit that she to say to the world that Jenny Jones is actually the real mother. But Jenny Jones was not the real mother. It was this lady, Bridget Allworthy, who was the real mother of Tom Jones. Okay, but all this happens in a very later stage at the end of the novel. This all happens we see the death of Bridget. She dies, Captain Blifil dies, and everybody gets to know that Tom is a very great person. He has been helping all the people all this while. He is a very kind and compassionate man. Everything falls back into place. And now Squire Western wants Sophia to get married to Tom. Okay. But Sophia at first she refuses. She thinks that Tom is not loyal, but then again, she is ready to get married to Tom, because after all, both of them are hero and heroine. Have to get that together. So this is Nathan, request to switch off your microphone. Yeah. So this is the novel. This is the plot of the novel, all in all. Okay, so it's so confusing. See, the narrator is trying to create so much of confusion here. Okay, by bringing so many characters. Okay, but the only thing that the novel deals with is who is the real parents of Tom Jones and the marriage of Tom and Sophia. So these two are the only themes of the novel. Rest, everything is created to actually bring that punch, that, you know, spiciness in that novel. Because it is a romantic novel, so it has to be a bit dramatic also. Okay, so
Thank you, ma'am. Wonderful lecture. Can we take some of my presentation? And please have a glass of water too.
Yeah. Listen, just a minute. As I said yesterday, I will also be giving them a few tips about how to write a good answer in the examination. So, in student, I'll just...
Next session, we can do yes. that.
Okay, yes, we can do that in the next session. No problem.
Too lengthy.
Okay, fine. We'll do that in the... Yeah, hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, yes, okay, fine. We can do that in the next session. No problem. You can please come up with the questions, learners.
Yeah, learners, you can directly interact with the resource person by asking the question directly to her. Okay? It would be quite good one.
Yeah, sure. Okay, so the first question is,
Om Bahadur can ask the question directly to the resource person. Om Bahadur?
Yes, you can ask it.
Yes. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes, good afternoon. Say.
Yes, my first question is about when we see this novel in basically in Wikipedia, it has been described as a picaresque novel. So I want to get your opinion and your answer about this novel. How can it be regarded as picaresque novel? Can you define me, ma'am?
See, first of all, your name is Om Bahadur, right? I would give you a suggestion, Om Bahadur. Do not trust Wikipedia blindly. Okay, because Wikipedia is an editable site. Anybody can come into Wikipedia, invade Wikipedia, and they can write whatever they want. Even today, if I want to write something in Wikipedia, I can write it on Wikipedia because it is an open source. Okay, it is open for everybody. All right, and it is not a picaresque novel. Okay, maybe some people might think it is a picaresque novel because you know Tom Jones is shown as a very he's shown as a philander or maybe a guy who is having a lot of affairs, but that is not the reality. Okay, deep down the reality is it is basic human nature. Okay, when we are alone, when we are lonely, we want a companion. Okay, and it happens. It is human tendency to fall in love with or to get attracted towards people who accompany us while we are alone.
Ma'am, may I answer the question?
Yeah, sure.
Om Bahadur, as you know, the very term picaresque has been, it means as a rogue, and how Tom Jones, being a roguish from the beginning, how he tries to develop his character, and in the end, he ultimately come victorious as a hero. So it's a kind of development novel, how a character is being developed. You can take the example of R.K. Narayan's A Guide, how the very character how he tried to improve himself and he becomes a sadhu by the end of the novel. So in this way, how a person attains his character and become victorious at the end. Okay, I hope you are getting.
So, ma'am.
Yes.
So, ma'am.
Yes.
Is it quite right if we will call this novel not the picaresque novel but a building novel?
I don't listen. Just a minute. See, I agree with what Heba Madam says, but for me, it is not a picaresque novel. Okay, we can term this novel as Bildungsroman. 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 It can be said as a Bildungsroman novel. What is a Bildungsroman novel? It is a novel dealing with the person's evolvement of the character or the protagonist. Okay, how the person has evolved from his childhood to the later ages of his life. This can be called as a Bildungsroman, but not really a picaresque novel. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Ma'am, I have two more questions, if you don't mind.
Please. Go on.
Ma'am, my next question is, what attitudes toward marriage does Fielding illustrate in this novel?
See,
marriage
you can,
or,
Okay, I'll tell you my perception. Okay, this is totally my perception. See, students, may you please switch off your microphone so that I can tell it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. See, literature, as I always say, main jis bhi class mein jaati hu, jo bhi class ko jaye na, I always say one thing, that literature is a study of perception. Science re, commerce re, maths re, you will have a definite answer to a question or a problem. But in literature, you will literally have a lot of definitions and a lot of perceptions and a lot of expressions. All right. So in my perception, and every perception is accepted in literature. You know, students, every perception, whatever you perceive about a novel is appreciated or is taken in literature. Like somebody, if he is saying that it's Tom Jones is a picaresque novel, okay, fine. If you can prove it, you can, it will be proved that it is a picaresque novel. Like I said that I feel Tom Jones is a Bildungsroman. So it is my perception that it is a Bildungsroman. Similarly, literature is actually a study of perception. And if we see, then Henry Fielding has a very pious and a very a very a very pure feeling of marriage is what I feel, because with all the ladies whosoever with whomsoever Tom had an affair, they didn't end up marrying. Okay, Tom finally married Sophia, who was his age old lover. So for me, it's my perception, it's my thought, it's my viewpoint that I think Henry Fielding is very serious about marriage, as things related to marriage, and he thinks that marriage is a very beautiful bond, and that is the reason why he didn't make his protagonist, he didn't make the hero of the novel marry every other woman he meets. Rather, they ended up having a short span of affair. Okay, now this calls for an example. I remember I forgot this point totally. Remember I told you about Henry Fielding's wife, Charlotte Cradock. She was the one whom Henry Fielding loved a lot. Okay, and you know, Sophia Western is actually portrayed as Charlotte Cradock. He has portrayed Sophia in the image of Charlotte Cradock, and he loved Charlotte Cradock a lot. And he and Charlotte Cradock was Henry Fielding's wife. So with this, you can know what kind of perception Fielding has towards marriage. Yes, ma'am. Am I clear? Yeah.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Anybody? Yeah. Okay.
Thank
now,
you,
okay. Yeah. Most welcome. There are a lot of questions. Okay. Yes. Let me read one by one. Yes. After. Hello.
May I have a question, ma'am?
Yes. 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 Please. Please.
Yes, ma'am. Shubhashree Pradhan is asking the question to the pregnant lady with whom Tom Jones was in love at first. Whose child was that?
See, this is where, you know, the state of confusion arises. Molly, there is no mention in the novel whose child Molly Seagrim had in his womb. Okay, that part is not clear to anybody. All right. And what happens to that pregnant child? What happens to that pregnant lady? Nobody knows. Nobody knows. Like in a movie, okay, when there is a happy ending, we are not told about the villain or what happened to the vamp in the story, right? So they might be living, they might not be living, they might have eloped, something might have happened. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Next question is asked by Sanjay Kumar Nayak. He's asking us to define comic novel.
Mm-hmm.
What's a comic novel?
Comic novel. See, may I please know the name of the person who is asking the question?
Sanjay Kumar Nayak, to directly ask the question to the resource person, it would be much more clear.
Yes. Yes.
Am I audible to
you? Okay. Yes. Okay, fine. I'll answer the question. What is a comic novel? Now, comic novel is obviously the novel that has a lot of, that deals with a lot of humor and satire. Satire, as I explained in the beginning of the novel, that comic novel is something. See, if you ask me as a genre, okay, comic novel. If I start talking about comic novel, it will take the entire day. Okay, there is a huge definition regarding comic novel if we go into the in-depths. Okay, but for now, a comic novel is a novel that is usually a work of fiction and that deals with, you know, humorous works or humorous acts. All right. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am. I think Sanjay sir is not replying anything. Then we are having
okay.
our next question.
Next question.
Regarding the characters of Tom Jones.
Okay, that's a wonderful question, and I'm happy that question actually came up. Okay, so Tom Jones as a person. Now, again, I'm giving my perception. You might have your perception, and you're free to have your perception. Okay, Tom Jones, for me, he is a kind of a person who is very kind-hearted, who is very generous, and but sometimes he is a bit fickle-minded. He is a bit confused. Which we all are. Okay, you know what the beauty of Tom Jones is, learners? Tom Jones, we can relate with Tom Jones at certain points. Okay, I as a young lady, I can relate with Tom Jones and his whatever he did in his youth time. I get attracted to people. I have physical attractions. I get attracted to people. If I see an actor, I get attracted towards him. If I see a person who is very good looking and charming and beautiful, I get attracted towards that person. So it is very natural. The beauty of Tom Jones is he is showing ground level, honest human desires. Okay. The only thing is, the only thing is what he does when he gets attracted towards a lady, he ends up having physical relationship with that lady, which we might think that, okay, it was not acceptable. But then we all know that all these things happen. Okay, maybe we can love someone with all our heart. Maybe we can love people. Maybe we can love someone for years together. But then this mere chota mota attraction, it happens. Okay, it happens in real life. But then that doesn't make us, a villain. That doesn't make us a very, immoral human being. We are all humans. We all tend to do mistakes. We all tend to learn from our mistakes. And that is what this novel teaches us about. All right. Any other question?
Thank you, ma'am. Again, the question I've lost the answer. Name is given that. How did
Captain Blifil already died. There is this session that Captain Blifil died of brain hemorrhage. But Bridget Allworthy, they have not mentioned how she died. It is just mentioned that the reality of Bridget Allworthy's the reality of Bridget Allworthy's that she is Tom Jones' mother, it was only revealed after she was dead. All right. And this fellow, Captain Blifil, he died out of brain hemorrhage. Okay. Then another question?
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, there is this, Heba. Sorry. Just 2 minutes. May I please intervene? 2 minutes. Yeah, see, there were a few questions while I was also teaching these students. Okay, which we have left, I guess. Somebody has asked, please mention the character of Nancy. Okay. I think I have told. Okay, then there was this question asked by Niharika. Ma'am, please mention again the name of the girls when Tom got relationship with them. You can count the name of the girls, students. There was this, ma'am, please mention again the name of the girls. Okay, Molly, Nancy, Lady Bellaston, Sophia, and who else? Mrs. Waters, and I guess these 5 ladies. Yes? Am I clear?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Then one more question is there.
Can we wind up?
There are 2 more questions. Let us finish and then we can wind up. Okay, 2 more questions. Okay, does Tom have love or lust? See, we cannot define it. I am not Tom Jones that I will define you. What is what did Tom have? Did he have love or did he have lust? Okay, in some parts it is shown that he had lust, which is obvious. As I said, that lust is a human attribute. It happens. Everybody faces lust in their phases of life. It happens. We just don't agree. Okay, we are very, we want to show very virtuous to, and hence we never agree that, okay, I'm lustful about this person or that person. But we also have lust. We also have love. We love somebody. We develop lust for somebody. That happens. That is very natural. So yeah, maybe he had lust for all those women with whom he had a short-term relationship, and maybe he was truly in love with Sophia. We can conclude it like that. Okay. Is society or family was responsible for his attitude towards lady have relationship relationship with so many girls? Society or family? No, I don't think so. Okay, I don't think so. Anybody's society or anybody's family is responsible. This is our quality. This is our quality that comes out. Okay, their samet ye quality nikal hi aati hai. All right, and we cannot blame the society. Okay, we can blame the society for till some extent, but then family, no. What wrong did Tom Jones family did to him? Only Blifil, that guy was very jealous of him, and Bridget Allworthy didn't accept his son. I don't think that was anywhere related to. Yes, we can say that that was Tom did it all this because he felt lonely, and he was despised by his mother, and he felt lonely, and all this came out of that. But I don't think that Tom was harmful towards any girls. He didn't harm anybody. Okay, he just wanted to suffice his loneliness, and that is why maybe he came in relationship with so many girls. Maybe that is the reason. Okay, if you put it like this, can the various episodes primarily in Tom Jones be dispensed with? What is Fielding's purpose behind the their inclusion in the novel? May I please ask Miss Piran Begum to unmute your mic and ask me the question? Yes, Miss Piran Begum. Hello. Hello. I think she is not here. I think she is not here. Miss Piran Begum.
Is there, but she is on my thing.
No. She just went offline. Okay, maybe we can answer to her question in the next class. Yes? Whenever she is there, because if I answer now to her question, it won't be of any use. Yes, so shall we wind up?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, I think she has joined. I think she has joined. Yes, yes, Piran, you wanted to ask something? I actually couldn't understand.
You would be writing that book also. And I'm only saying that Piran, if you would be directly able to interact with the resource person, it would be much more clear. Answer your question. Please interact
yes.
with the person. Piran Begum.
I actually couldn't. I mean, her question is, I cannot make out what is her name.
Yeah,
what is her question? It's a bit.
She's okay,
but I think. Yeah, no problem. I think she's not able to. She's having some network issues. Okay, no problem. Piran, if you are listening, then we will definitely clear your doubt in the next class. Do not worry. This is not the first class. We will have a lot more classes like this. Okay, and in the next class, students, we will discuss about another novel and maybe a novel or a drama. And then we will discuss about the writing style, okay, in which you can write or frame the answers in your examination. All right. And I would please ask you to fill the feedback form sent by Bigya Prabha, ma'am. Please go to the feedback form and share your responses, and you might end. I mean, I think we are good to end the meeting, Miss Heba. Heba, ma'am.
Thank you for the insight and wonderful lecture. And you tried to present
a Can we end the meeting here? Can we end the meeting here?
And the participants were really, really. Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for the wonderful lecture. Thanks,
yeah.
ma'am.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot. Okay, bye students. Have a nice day. You may exit the meeting one by one.
Hello.
Hello.
Ma'am.
Ma'am.
Thank you so much.
No, okay, most ma'am. Welcome, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Okay.